Hello, dear students. Good morning, everyone. Children, you may have realized that there is a fixed place for everything. Land is a natural resource. Different parts of land is used in different way. Today we are going to study in this chapter land use, and how the land is distributed and how it is used by man. Land use is the way or purpose for which land in a region is used. Land use undergoes changes with time. As man's needs have increased, the use of land for different purposes has also increased. Let us study now the types of land use. Rural land use. In rural areas, agriculture is the main occupation. Agro-based activities are also common in rural areas. This influences the location for the rural settlements. Hence, these settlements are located close to the agricultural fields and forest areas. In rural areas, the availability of land is more and the population is less. Hence, population is sparse. In rural areas, the extent of residential areas is less. As you can see here, the houses are very far from each other and the land is distributed for different farms. Land use in the rural areas can be classified in the following manner. First is arable land. This is the land under cultivation. It is under individual ownership. Next is fallow land. This is agricultural land which is temporarily not in use. In order to improve the fertility of the soil, the farmer does not use a part of his agricultural land for one or two seasons. For few seasons, they do not use the land. They do not grow any crops in that land to regain the fertility of the soil. Next is forest land. From this area, forest products like firewood, gum, and grass are obtained. Forests comprise of large trees, bushes, creepers, and grass. Next is grassland or pasture land. This land is under the ownership of the village panchayat or the government and is used for grazing purpose. This land belongs to the entire village. Very little grassland is under individual ownership. Next type is urban land use. There has been an increase in urban settlements in the 20th century. In urban areas, land is used for different purposes. Therefore, the distribution of population is dense. Urban land use can be classified in the following manner. First is the commercial land use. Some parts of cities are only used for commercial purposes. Example, for shops, banks, and offices, etc. The CBD, that means the Central Business District. This has given rise to the concept of the CBD, that means the Central Business District. Example, in Mumbai, the Fort area, or the BKC, that is Bandra Kurla Kurla Complex. It comes under the commercial land use. Next is residential land use. With the name, we can understand that for what purpose this type of land is used. In this area, houses are residential buildings, and residential buildings are included. Since the population is more in the urban areas, residential land use has increased. Next is transport land use. In urban areas, transportation facilities are important for the movement of goods and people. Unless and until there is transport area, how we will move from one place to another? So in urban area, a part of land is used for transport. The transportation facilities are public bus stops, railway lines, metro, monorail, commercial vehicles, etc. In addition to this, the number of private vehicles is also large. Now we are staying in urban land use. So you must have experienced the different types of land uses in your area. In cities, roads, railway lines, station, petrol pumps, transport depots, and vehicle repair centers occupy large areas. Next is public utility area. For the various needs of the population, some services are provided by the local governing bodies, state government or central government. The area under these services comes under the category, example, hospitals, post offices, police stations, police grounds, schools, colleges, universities, etc. The land use under the category is important. These services diffuse the tensions caused due to burgeoning population. Next is recreational land use. In cities, some areas have to be specially reserved for the entertainment of the population. The use of such spaces is mainly for fields, gardens, swimming pools, theaters, etc. Last one is mixed land use. This type of land includes residential areas and entertainment areas. In some areas, we find all these uses together. Such areas are said to have mixed land uses. Example, residential areas and entertainment areas. On maps, special colors are used to indicate such areas. Red residential, blue commercial, yellow agricultural, and green forest areas. Now let us know about the transitional areas and suburbs. Rural settlements start outside the boundary areas of urban settlements, but the intermediate area in between is called the transitional area. In these areas, land is of a mixed nature. Over time, this area is converted to an urban area and these regions become suburbs. Example, Bandra, Bandup, etc. are suburbs of Mumbai city. Now there are planned cities also. After the Industrial Revolution, urbanization occurred on a large scale throughout the world. Since this urbanization was not well planned, cities began to grow in a haphazard manner. That means in anyhow structure. There was no proper planning of the cities, that which land should be used for residence, for commercial purpose, for industries. They just start building up the cities without any planning. As a result, the availability of land is always a serious problem in cities. A lot of diversity is visible in the land use of cities. Limited land, varied land uses, and burgeoning cities resulted in the thought of having planned cities for the future. So even before a city grows, its land use is predetermined and a planned layout is prepared. Accordingly, the cities are developed. Examples are Singapore, Seoul, that is in South Korea, Zurich in Switzerland, Washington DC in USA, Brasilia, Brazil, Chandigarh, Bhubaneswar in India, etc. are all examples of planned cities. Now this is the figure 6.1. Land use in Japan and India. Different colors are used to show the agricultural land, the forest, the pastures, etc. So you can study this figure and answer the questions below. Let us know about the Satbara extract. Under land utilization, we have seen how land is put to different uses. The ownership of land could be private or public. Land registration in this context is done under the Revenue Department of the government. All the information about the registered land can be obtained from the Revenue Department in the Satbara extract. One can get to know under whose ownership the land is from the Satbara extract. So from the Satbara extract, what we can get or what we can come to know, that under whose ownership the land is. The extract is a record kept by the Public Revenue Department. Serial number 7 and 12. 7 and 12 are distinctive sections of the law pertaining to the ownership of land. The 7 and 12 extract is a kind of mirror about the land. This is because just by reading the extract sitting in one place, one can get complete information about that piece of land without actually going there. How is the Satbara extract read? Occupant class 1 means the land over which ownership rights are available through generations. This is ancestral property. Occupant class 2 means the land given by the government to marginal farmers or landless people. Such land can be sold, leased, pledged, given as charity or transferred only with the sanctions of the district collector. Below that, under assessment, the amount of tax levied on the land is given in rupees paise. In other rights, the names of other joint holders are included. This also shows the status of loans taken for agriculture and whether they have been repaid or not. On page 38, figure 6.2, a sample of Satbara is given. You can refer to that. And on page number 39, figure 6.3, property card sample is given. Go through that. Let us know about property card. Ownership of non-agricultural land is recorded on the property card. This document showing ownership rights and the area of the property is made available from urban land records. It has the following information: city survey number, plot number, amount of tax, area of the property assessed, right to access, etc. You can study the figure 6.4, general land use and its changes in India. Now let us know about the factors affecting land use. Rural land use. Which factors affect rural land use? Climate, soil, type of slope, irrigation facilities, natural resources, government policies. Urban land use, that means the city areas. The factors which affect are location and site, natural resources, housing development policies, transportation routes, industrialization, trade and commerce, playgrounds and entertainment facilities, government policies. Children, there is one more figure. Give it a try. Can study that diagram also. Maharashtra state land use 2010-11. How much is the non-agricultural area, fallow land, area under crops is given in that figure. You can study that. On page number 41 also, under give it a try, there are different pictures given. Observe those figures. Children, I hope you have understood the meaning of land use, the different types and how they are affected, how they are distributed. Now let us come to exercise. Question 1. Examine the statements and correct the incorrect ones. First is, mining is not a type of land use. False. Mining falls under the category of rural land use. Next, there are factories in the central business district. False. CBD, that is central business district, has maximum land concentration for commercial purposes. Example, banks, shops, etc. In urban areas, the largest area is used for residential purposes. True. Because the population is high in the urban areas. The village attendant issues the Satbara extract. False. The Satbara extract is issued by the revenue of the government. In rural areas, residential areas occupy large tracts. False, they occupy less tracts. Extract 7 indicates record of rights. True. Extract 12 indicates change in ownership. False. It indicates about the registration of crops, type of crop. Next question is give reasons. Land use for public facility and are extremely important in urban areas. Write the answer in points. You can take a screenshot of this. Next question. The record of the ownership of non-agricultural land is the same as that of the agricultural land. Next is, a region can be classified as developed or developing on the basis of land use. Question number 3 is write answers. Why is agriculture important in rural land use? Answer is given to you. You have to write this answer in points. State the factors affecting land use. This is on page number 40. So, in the same way, you can copy it from the textbook or you can make two columns and write it. Next question is, clarify the differences between rural and urban land uses. So, this answer also, you can make two columns, rural land use and urban land use. And under that, you can write points to differentiate both. Differentiate between Satbara extract and property card. For this answer also, you can make two columns and write the answer in points. You can write in two paragraphs also, make two different paragraphs for Satbara extract and property card. Write all the answers in your classwork notebook. From question 1 till question 3, write all the question and answers in your classwork notebook neatly. Keep your notebook complete. Don't draw any diagrams in the classwork from this chapter. Read the lesson. Thank you, dear children. Have a good day.